The Philippine government urged to intervene in the hike in fees at Manila's international airport. The group Airport Watch called on the government to listen to public opposition on the move. It also said improvements at the NAIA should be delivered first by its private operator before any increase in airport fees. The group warns the hike in parking dues would burden ordinary passengers, and only the wealthy ones can afford it. A regional airport in southwest Japan is ordered shut after a World War II bomb exploded near its runway. The incident at the Miyazaki Airport Wednesday led to the cancellation of dozens of flights. No injuries were reported. A bomb disposal team believes the bomb was American-owned and was buried beneath land surface during a wartime air raid.
Two of the Philippines' brightest stars are set to return to stage with a Filipino adaptation of a German drama film. Tony Award winner Lea Salonga and Golden Globe nominee Dolly De Leon will be the alternating leads of the highly anticipated Request sa Radio. Its limited run will last from October 10 to 20. The play features an overseas Filipino worker grappling with loneliness while living in New York. De Leon says the protagonist reflects the reality of OFWs worldwide.
She represents every Filipino who has left home to find greener pastures in other countries. Okay. They've made sacrifices. She has made a sacrifice to leave her family, let go of the comforts of home. And for me, that's a very, it's a very important story to tell because a lot of our kababayans are living that life. Uh-oh.
The third day of the filing of certificates of candidacy for the 2025 elections has ended. Let's get the highlights today from our correspondent, Ara Perez. Hi, Ara.
Hi, Ron. Good afternoon. This afternoon, Manila 1st District Representative Ernix Junicio filed his certificate of candidacy for re-election. Joining him, our former Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, Chi Atienza, daughter of former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza. Moreno and Atienza are reportedly running for Manila Mayor and Vice Mayor. Here, Moreno was also asked about incumbent and re-electionist Manila Mayor Honey Lacuna, who said there will be no more room for a comeback, echoing her supporters.
Peace be with you. Hayaan ko na lang ang taong bayan sa Maynila ang sumagot. Ipepresenta lang namin yung mga nagawa natin at pwede pang gawin.
Meantime, former Taguig Mayor Lino Cayetano is aiming for a political comeback as Taguig 1st District Representative. He says he is also fully endorsing Taguig Mayor Lani Cayetano, who is reportedly eyeing re-election. Lawyer and broadcaster Attorney Virgilio Garcia, former Presidential Security Group under President Rodrigo Duterte, Francisco Palma, and independent candidate R.B. Bernardo aspire to become representatives of QC's 2nd District. From October 1 to 3, 31 lawmakers aspirants have filed their COCs here.
Thanks for the update, Ara. The National Investigation Bureau files complaints against ex-Mayor Alice Guo and five others in connection with an allegedly falsified counter-affidavit. The complaints filed at the Justice Department include falsification by a notary public, use of falsified documents, perjury, and obstruction of justice. Elmer Galicia, who notarized the counter-affidavit, are among those accused. He had claimed Guo appeared before him to subscribe and swore on the document last August 14. But authorities later found Guo fled the country in July.